Abrahamic tradition is defined as religion, means in a way, there is variation of opinions, but in a way it is saying realigning humanity with God, or looking for linkages between humanity and God, realigning, religion. That's the basis of the word religion. The Hindic religions start in a different mode, all of them share the same word. Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, they share the same root. Just as Abraham is the root of the Abrahamic, the Indic traditions have a root called Dharma. Same word used in Buddhism, slight different different pronunciation, they call it Dhamma, but same word, Dharma. What does that mean? Dharma really is not linking man with God. It is unusual, it's different. It is looking for, if you like, trying to discern the human condition, to understand what is the nature of this reality that we live in. What is all this that is going around me? Who am I? How am I linked to the rest of reality? It is trying to address the human condition. That's what it is all about. It is we wish to know if there is some kind of commonality, some underpinning that links this diversity that I experience. Is there some unity in the diversity that I experience? I'm searching for that unity. This is the definition of what Dharma. It says that which holds everything together. In simplistic term, you can say we are looking for rules and laws that dictate the world, the external world, the physical world. We're also looking at the world, the rules that dictate the inner man. So what is the inner man? The inner man is, you see, our inner faculties we sometimes ignore. What are they? They are like, for example, intellect, mind, linguistic, if you like, our scope and limitations. We sometimes forget to address this. When you are trying to discern your human nature, human condition, you must make sense of the world that you live in, the world external as well as the world internal. And sometimes we forget the internal world. So now, of course, in modern terms, you know, we look at anthropology, you look at social sciences, you look at psychology. This is the way of, if you like, addressing the issue of inner man. So the word Dharma encompasses both these enterprises, saying that making sense of the world we live in, what are the rules and laws that dictate the external world, as well as the rules and laws that dictate the inner man. We wish to understand them, come to terms with them, and harness them for our betterment. That is the application of Dharma. It is, in fact, that the simplest language to say is discerning the human condition, addressing the human condition, and resolving it. You see, even though we feel we are comfortable as human beings, there are issues that cannot continue to rattle us. So we are trying to find a way of addressing an end, if you like, resolving the human condition. It needs to be resolved, and that's what we are about. This is the definition of the word Dharma. So you can see under the same umbrella, you can have Buddhism, there is no God. You can have Jainism, again, no creator God. You can have Hinduism with its multi-variety of God. So in the same tradition, under the same umbrella, lies this variety of different approaches, all trying to address the human condition. That is the underpinning. It's nice for you to make the distinction straight away.